If 1/5 of, 1/3 of, 1/2 of a number is 750, the number is. X into 1/5 into 1/3 into 1/2 is equal to 750. 1/3 of, 1/3 of, 1/2 of a number. Therefore, X is equal to 22,500. 18th problem. 17th problem. If 1/8 of, 2/3 of, 4/5 of a number is 600, 30% of that number is. Seventeenth problem. 1/8 of 2/3 of 4/5 of a number is 600. Answer is 2700. Question number 18. The sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 8. If the digits are reversed, the number is reduced by 54. The number is. Two-digit number, you take it as 10x plus y. Two-digit number, you take it as 10x plus y. Sum of two numbers is 8. This is first equation. Sum of two numbers is 8. When the numbers are reversed, that is 10y plus x is equal to 10x plus y minus 54. So this is 10x plus y minus 10y minus x is equal to 54. 9x minus 9y is equal to 54. X minus y is equal to 6. Cancel with the 9. Now first equation is x plus y is equal to 8. Second equation is x minus y is equal to 6. 2x is equal to 14. X is equal to 7. X is equal to 7. 2x is equal to 14. X is equal to 7. When x is equal to 7, y is equal to 1. Therefore, required number is 10x plus y. Therefore, required number is 10x plus y. 10 into 7 plus 1 is 71. So, answer is 71. That is multiple choice D. This problem, you can also go with multiple choices. this problem, you can also go with multiple choices. How to go with multiple choices? 41, 51, 61, 71. Reverse of 41 is 14. Difference is 29. But question says difference should be 54. So this is not the answer. This is also not the answer. This is also not the answer. If you reverse 71, you will get 70. 71 minus 17 is 54. When the digits are reversed, difference is decreased by 54. 19th problem. In a two-digit number, the digit in the units place is more than the digit in the tens place by 2. If the difference between the number and the number obtained by interchanging the digits is 18, the original number is... Original number, you take it as 10x plus y. Original number, you take it as 10x plus y. Then y is equal to x plus 2. Or y is equal to x minus 2. This is one equation, this one equation you can form. Then 10y plus x. 10y plus x minus 10x plus y is equal to 18. So 10y plus x minus 10y minus y is equal to 18. 9y minus 9x is equal to 18. Y minus x is equal to 2. So y, that is, y is equal to x minus 2. That is, y is equal to x minus 2. Y is equal to x minus 2. So from these two equations, we cannot do anything. So answer is data insufficient. Question number 20. The sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 8. If the digits are reversed, the number is increased by 54. The number is... This problem we can go with multiple choices. Reverse, so this will be wrong, this is also wrong. Reverse of 17 is 71, so 71 and 17 difference is 54, so answer is C. Question number 21. If the ratio of the sum and the difference between two numbers is 7:1, the ratio of these two numbers are question number 21. Two numbers x and y. X plus y is equal to 7. X minus y is equal to 1. 2x is equal to 8. X is equal to 4. Y is equal to 3. x by y is equal to 4:3. So answer is 4:3. 22nd question. The difference between a two-digit number and the number obtained by interchanging the digits is 27. Then the difference and the sum of the two digits of the number is. So two-digit number, we will take it as 10x plus y. Two-digit number, we will take it as 10x plus y. Two-digit number, we will take it as 10x plus y. Question number 22. So you can find the difference, but you cannot find the sum. You can find the difference, you cannot find out the sum. That is the answer. 23rd problem. The difference between the two digits of a two-digit number is 1/9 of the difference between the original number and the number obtained by interchanging the positions of the digits. The sum of the digits of that number is. Question number 23. X minus y from this you cannot do anything, so data is insufficient. Question number 24. A certain number when successively divided by 8 and 11 leave remainders 3 and 7 respectively, then the complete remainder is. So write down something about complete remainder. Complete remainder. A remainder obtained by dividing a given number by the method of successive division is called a complete remainder. A remainder that is obtained by dividing a given number by the method of successive division is called complete remainder. That is the definition. Now write down the formula. Complete remainder is equal to D1 R2 plus R1. Suppose there are three divisors D1, D2, D3 and three remainders R1, R2, R3. Suppose, let us assume there are three divisors D1, D2, D3 and three remainders R1, R2, R3. Then the formula will be D1, D2, R3, D1, D2, R3 plus D1, R2 plus D1. This is for three divisors. CR is equal to d1 or 2 plus or 1 divided by 8 and 11. So d1 is 8, d2 is 11, remainder 3 and 7. R1 is equal to 3, R2 is equal to 7. Now apply the formula D1 R2 plus R1. 8 into 7, 56 plus 3, 59. So answer is 59.